गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम गायत्री मनवाड़े, लेक्चरर इन एडीएफटी जीपीडब्ल्यू हुबली। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ सेशन ऑन कॉस्ट्यूम्स एंड दिस इज द 8th सेशन। नाउ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग ऑल अदर स्टेट्स कॉस्ट्यूम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट आवर रीजनल स्टेट कॉस्ट्यूम, दैट इज Karnataka. However, the style of draping the sari varies along with the variations in regions across the state. Davani is also one of the common ethnic dresses of this Karnataka state. The traditional dress for Kannada men is a type of dhoti known as panche, worn under the waist, below a shirt and topped off with the conventional headdress Mysore para or peta. This entire look is adorned with angavastram, which is a piece of cloth worn above the shoulder to cover the upper portion of the body. Men in Karnataka wear it with or without kurta. Women in Karnataka wear silk saris viewed by the artisans with precision and fineness. The saris are crafted in a variety of materials such as traditional Mysore or Bangalore silk saris and cotton sarees. These sarees are not only popular in Karnataka but also well known throughout India and some portions of other countries too. Every Indian woman has desired buy a traditional Kanchipuram saree at some point in her life. Even though there is a wide range of styles, designs and color combinations available in Kanchipuram sarees, this is one of the cultural costume of our Karnataka. The traditional ones are made in red, pink, cream, red and white colors. Kanchipuram or Kanjivaram sarees of Karnataka come in fabulous designs and are really smooth, soft and lustrous. Handmade by the artisans, these sarees are dyed and then adorned with zari work to give them the richness of South Indian culture. One more specific sari culture is Kodugu. Women of Kodugu district wear sari in different way. The pleats are tied at the back and the pallu is placed over the shoulder at the right side, front side. A traditional Kodugu sari is made with both silk and cotton. The motifs crafted on these sarees are vibrant and represent the culture of Karnataka. The body of the saree is adorned with prints, stripes or floral patterns. One more traditional saree of Karnataka is Ilkal saree. It is woven using cotton warp on the body and art silk warp for the border and pallu portion of the sari. The main body of the Ilkal sari consists of simple patterns and a gorgeous pallu consists of flattering motifs such as temple towers, palanquins, elephants and lotuses. The main attraction of an Ilkal sari is their border, which is about 4 to 6 inches broad. Both bottom and pallu of the sari contain eye-catching borders that give an incredible look to the sari. The colors that are usually used in the sari are pomegranate red, peacock green and parrot green, with the combination of red and maroon color. Even white is used in these saris, and borders are elegant with golden color. The other traditional costume of Karnataka is Mysore silk saris. Mysore silk saris are made with authentic silk. The Mysore is known as the land of silk and sandalwood. Karnataka produces the highest mulberry silk in India. Mysore silk saris come into existence in 1785 AD. Mysore saris are famous for its quality of silk, which gives a smooth texture and rich feel. It is also one of the most expensive silk saris in India. These saris are best suitable for wedding and functions because of its grand and luxury look. Quality of silk ensures that the sari has a long life and requires minimal maintenance. While the traditional Mysore silk saris are embellished with zari borders, the modern ones are being adorned with motifs other than zari, such as mango butties and floral butties or borders. One more traditional sari of Karnataka is Gulegud. Gulegud Khana, hailing from Gulegud, a village in the Bagalkot district of North Karnataka and spanning over 100 years. The fabric is often collectively known as Gulegud Khana, with Khana being a prominent blouse and sari fabric of the state. Especially this Khana is worn in the North Karnataka as well as in some parts of Maharashtra. Now this Khana is famous for new age fashion. Khana is now used as a dress material to create shirts, bags and pillow covers and many more home decorative items as well as furnishing purpose too. Pattidanchu sari weavers from Karnataka have kept alive one such ancient weave from the 10th century, named after the pattern, border and checks. These Pattidanchu saris are very popular in Karnataka due to their check spot pattern as well as simple plain border, striped border, especially designed for working women in the farms. This sari is made in cotton and has a specific color palette that includes shades like yellow, red, pink and green. Nowadays, these saris have become more famous among working women as they look perfect for professional wear. Kasuti is traditional form of embroidery designed on the saris in northern parts of Karnataka. First, the design is drawn from the pencil on the sari and then they sieve the design with needle and colorful threads, which make it appear beautiful. The kasuti design is embroidered on any saree like cotton saree, silk saree or raw silk sarees. The kasuti sarees are very famous throughout India for their elegant and intricate patterns. Thank you so much. I hope you all have enjoyed the traditional costumes sessions. Thank you.